So friends, today we will discuss about the thermodynamic processes. In the last lecture, we have seen about the thermodynamic system. Now, actually, every thermodynamic system, whether it is any kind, is working under the some thermodynamic manner, and that manner is normally considered as process. And ideally, you have to keep in mind about the polytropic process. The thermodynamic process, major thermodynamic processes on which any mechanical element works is considered as polytropic process. So for understanding of the polytropic process, you have to state the state or condition of the substance working in thermodynamic system is normally considered as expansion or compression. Suppose say we have to take one example of mechanical system like your two-wheeler, in which in two-wheeler engine cylinder one component is there, piston. So what happens in the engine cylinder under the suction stroke, the piston is pushing towards the down of the cylinder, so that the gas mixture, air fuel mixture, is compressed, and piston is moving upward outside the cylinder. Then the gas or air mixture is expanded and released through the exhaust stroke. So this is about how every mechanical system, mechanical thermodynamic system, is working. Okay. So you have to keep in mind about the condition of the substance in, that is working under the any mechanical system. So you have to assume that the working substance, the condition of the working substance, condition means whether its temperature may be changing, pressure may be changing, volume may be changing. So you have to keep in mind about the relation between pressure and volume, and temperature and enthalpy both. Temperature is with enthalpy and pressure is with volume. So what happens here, in which what happens here, actually you have to see with this example, with this figure. The state 1 represents the original condition and state 2 represents the final condition on PV diagram. So pressure of the substance is P1, initial pressure of the substance is P1 and volume is V1, and final substance means final condition of the substance is 2. So pressure is P2, just you have to see here, pressure is P2 and volume is V2. So condition number 1 or condition number. So condition number 1 is for initial condition and condition number 2 is for final condition. Now your thermodynamic process is starting from point 1 to point 2. So when it is going from point 1 to point 2, pressure P1 is reduced to P2. So pressure is reducing, at the same time volume is changing from V1 to V2. So volume is increasing. And as we already seen, when temperature remains constant according to the Boyle's law, as we already means you know in physics even also, that whenever pressure is decreased, volume is increased, or vice versa. So this happens here in every thermodynamic process. Okay, so this is about the thermodynamic process. Now here what we have to do is, you have to keep in mind about these things. And we are trying to convert, actually we are trying to convert this scenario, this graphical representation into mathematics. So how we can convert it in form of equation, because to understand the thermodynamic process, to calculate the examples, or to find out the condition of the different various kind of thermodynamic process, I mean we have to find out the pressure, volume, at how it, in what content volume is changing, what are the variation in the pressure and volume, you must need the mathematical equation. So for predicting the mathematical behavior of this process, keep in mind about this diagram in your mind and convert it into log scale. Convert it into logarithmic scale. Okay, logarithmic scale. So instead of P, we have to put it as log P, and instead of V, we have to put it as log V, and same that diagram is to be converted like this. Approximately parabolic curve is to be considered as straight line, as we have converted it into logarithmic scale. Okay, we have to convert it into logarithmic scale. Now, how we can reduce the mathematical equation? Mathematical equation means we have to convert this mathematical representation of this line. So how, what is the equation for representing the line in mathematics? Y is equal to mx plus c. Okay, y is equal to mx plus c. Y means log v is equal to m means slope, x means log p plus c. C means constant. So how we can convert it into just to see y is equal to mx plus c. Here slope is negative. We have already studied in physics also. This slope is negative. Positive slope is like this. So this is negative slope. Okay, pressure is reducing. So just you have to see here. Y is equal to mx plus c. Y means log p. Okay, x means log v. So log p is equal to mx minus minus. Why you have to represent it as minus? Because the negative slope. Okay, m instead of m we have to put n in the mechanical engineering elements of mechanical engineering. We have to put it as m, n instead of m, then log v mx plus log c, that is constant. So n is the slope and it is negative. N is the slope and it is negative. Okay, intercept of the axis. So log p plus log plus n into log v is equal to log c. Now mathematically, if we convert log into raised to form, power form, then p is equal to v raised to l. P is equal to v raised to l. Here this n becomes raised to. Here by default we are assuming it as 1. There's nothing is there. So c raised to 1, p raised to 1. Here we are assuming it as 1. There is nothing intercept. Okay. So now p into v raised to n is equal to c. So this is the fundamental equation of any thermodynamic process. So the fundamental equation of any thermodynamic process, and it is famously known as the polytropic process. P into v raised to n is equal to constant. So p1 v1 raised to n is equal to p2 v2 raised to n. Okay, so how we can remove this? Just have to see P1 V1 raised to N is equal to P2 V2 raised to N. Okay, so this is about the polytropic process, fundamental equation of any mechanical thermodynamic process. Keep in mind about this. Okay, now what you have to do is you have to keep in mind about the slope. Various kind of the slopes is important here. So your slope, your straight, your line may be inclined, your line may be straight, your line may be horizontal, your line may be vertical. So if n is equal to 0, suppose you have to assume that n is equal to 0, n is equal to 0 means your line is horizontal. N is equal to 0 means your slope is 0, straight line. What happens here? You have to put n is equal to 0. If v raised to 0 is equal to constant, then v raised to 0 means 1. So pressure remains constant. Now you have to put n is equal to 0 in this figure. Put n is equal to 0 in this figure. Put n is equal to 0. So pv is equal to constant. So pv is equal to constant. P is equal to constant. Sorry. P is equal to constant means there is no change of the pressure. No change of the pressure means like this. No drop of the pressure. So p1 is equal to this. P2 is equal to this. If n is equal to 0. Keep in mind, there is slope 0. Now, every time it is not possible that n is equal to 0. Sometimes n may be infinitive. Infinitive means 100%, straight line. Then what happens? Your volume is constant. Just have to see here. This is V1. This is V2. So here you have to see this is V1. At the same time, V2 is there. So this is straight line. Okay. So P1 is this, P2 is this. So pressure is reducing, but volume is V1 is this, V2 is this. So for straight line, horizontal line, pressure remains constant, and for vertical line, where n is equal to infinity, your volume remains constant. Okay, so two cases are there that I will explain you by means of this figure. By means of this figure, two things are there. Okay. Okay. Then n is equal to 1 and n is equal to infinity. And third case is n is equal to 1. Okay. So if you put n is equal to 1, if you put n is equal to 1, so p is equal to constant. So p1 v1 is equal to p2 v2. And this polytopic process is called as the hyperbolic process. Now here you have to keep in mind about the three scenarios. Keep in mind about the three scenarios. Okay. I will explain you one by one again. Then n is equal to 0. This process is called as the constant pressure process. Okay. Then n is equal to infinity, then it is called as the constant volume process. By volume process, n is equal to infinity means p raised to infinity is equal to 0. Constant. So p raised to 1 upon infinity is equal to v is equal to constant. So 1 upon infinity is equal to 0 into v is equal to constant. So v volume is equal to constant. Okay. So based on this equation, you have to see one example on this. So guess, you see this, how mechanical engineering is actually working. So gas, normally in IC engine, air mixer, air gas, petrol and air mixer is in form of gas is normally used. So here you can see how actually the any product polytopic process or mechanical process works. So here you can see a gas with volume of 0.02 meter cube is expanded to 0.11 meter cube. Okay, according to the polytropic process. So polytropic process means PV raised to n is equal to constant. That equation you have to apply in this problem. What you have to determine? Determine the work done during this process. If initial pressure is given, an exponent is taken as 1.2 to 1.5, but here it is given as 1.3 directly. So how you can see this problem, how we are trying to solve this problem, just you have to see. V1 is given, initial volume is given, final volume is given, pressure is given, pressure P2 is not given, exponent is given, work done we have to find out. Work done equation is what? P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1 for any polytropic process as we have derived in the previous theory. So here what is that? P2 is not given. So first of all, what we have to find out? First of all, we have to find out the P2. So how we can find out P2? You can use this equation P1 V1 raised to N is equal to P2 V2 raised to N. Or simple equation is what? PV raised to N is equal to constant. So PV raised to N is equal to PV raised to N is equal to constant. That is the equation, fundamental equation for any polytropic process. From this equation, P1 V1 raised to N is equal to P2 V2 raised to N. Then use this another data that is given in your data is putting E1, V1, V2 and N, then find out the P2 first, and based on the P2, use this equation of work done and get it in kilonewton per meter or kilojoule. So keep in mind about the conversion of units. Okay. Now we already seen hyperbolic process. In hyperbolic process, what happens? N is equal to 1. N is equal to 0. N is equal to infinity is for constant volume process, constant pressure process. And N is equal to 1 is for hyperbolic process. So PV raised to constant. PV is equal to constant. So P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 as N is equal to 1. And work done for polytropic process is this. P1 V1 minus P2 V2 is divided by N minus 1. But practically it is not possible. So hyperbolic process, if it is hyperbolic process, work done is 0, but it is not possible. For any polytropic process, suppose you are supplying the energy, then work done never becomes 0 because energy can be transferred, energy cannot be destroyed, but it can be transferred from one form to another form. So this equation is not valid for hyperbolic process. So what happens here? For hyperbolic process, same equation you have to follow. Work done is equal to P into delta V. So PV is equal to constant. Both the equation, same equation you have to use. PV is equal to constant. So P is equal to C upon V or C into V minus 1. Okay. So this equation you have to follow. And same fundamentals you have to use. C common. Integration V1 to V2 dV by V. So ln V2 by V1, so PV is equal to ln V2 by V1, where V2 by V1 is called as the volumetric ratio. So this is the fundamental equation for finding the work done for hyperbolic process where exponent n is equal to exactly 1. And an example for hyperbolic process, just you have to see here. So gas is compressed hyperbolically, not polytropically. Hyperbolically means specifically n is not given. So you have to assume that n is equal to 1 and use the equation for hyperbolic process. From a pressure is given, volume is given, and pressure is given, final pressure is given. So final volume you have to calculate and work done you have to calculate. So first of all, P1, you want to list it out given data. P1, V1, P2, V2, and work done is fine. So P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. This is the initial condition. V1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So you have to find out V2. First you have to find out V2, and then from V2, once you get the V2, then you have to use this equation. Work done is equal to P1 V1 ln V2 by V1. As P1 is V1 is equal to P2 V2. The final equation is what? PV is equal to ln by ln V2 by V1. But here instead of PV, you can put P1 V1 or P2 V2, anything, because both are same. So you can use P1 V1 ln V2 by V1 or P2 V2 ln V2 by V1. Okay. Simultaneously, you can use any equation and put the equation and find out the work done. If it is positive, then work done by the gas. Positive for any thermodynamic process, for any polytropic process, if your answer is in positive, then it seems that work done is by the gas. Gas has provided the work. But if it is negative, then what happens? Work done on the gas, not by the gas, but work done on the gas. So reverse process is there. So work done minus means work is consumed, energy is consumed. Okay, just like refrigerator or air conditioner. But in case of power producing devices, it is always positive. But in case of power consuming devices, it is negative. A kind of thing is there. So that is the symbolic representation or importance of the or significance of the symbol in the final answer. Positive means work done by the gas and negative means work done on the gas. So that is the fundamental difference between these things. In the next lecture, we have to see the fundamental gas laws like Boyle's law, Charles' law and Galilei's law.